Hey there.
If you ever tried to create reports in spreadsheets, you know the struggle. At first, it seems simple. You pull in your data and add a few formulas, maybe even create a chart. But as you try to update regularly or share it with your team, things start falling apart. In this video, I'll show you how Looker Studio can solve the biggest headaches that can come with spreadsheets reports, making your dashboards truly dynamic, automated, and easy to collaborate on. But before we dive into Looker Studio, let's talk about the real problems with spreadsheets. If you ever spend hours copying and pasting new data into spreadsheets, updating formulas, and double checking your numbers, you know how tedious it can get. The more reports you manage, the worse it gets. And if you forget to update one cell, that error can cascade across your entire report. Another problem? Human error. One wrong formula, one accidental delete, and your whole dataset can become unreliable. Plus, when multiple people work on the same file, things get even messier. Columns get moved, formulas break, and suddenly your report isn't telling the real story anymore. Spreadsheets let you create charts. While they are somewhat dynamic, they still feel static. Want to filter multiple visualizations or graphs by a specific date range or focus on one department? You'll have to create multiple tables and charts for each view. It's not scalable and it's definitely not user-friendly. If your report is getting too big, loading times slow down. And if you need to share it with a team, you have to manage permissions manually. Plus, not everyone knows how to navigate a complicated spreadsheet. The more people you need to access, the more confusing it gets for them. For a long time, I stuck with spreadsheets for reporting, and I ran into every single one of the problems that I mentioned before. Then I found Looker Studio, and it completely changed the way I work with data. No more endless copy-pasting or broken formulas. Looker Studio connects directly to data sources, so my reports update automatically. It also makes it easy to build dynamic dashboards where I can filter and drill down into details without creating separate reports. And sharing? It's as simple as sending a link. No more version control headaches. Let me show you exactly what I mean. I'm going to share my screen now and walk you through how to set up Looker Studio dashboard from scratch. Okay, now that we wanna start creating our dashboard using data from Google Sheets, we are gonna use this sample data where you can see here we have columns and the columns are date format. It's also product, and this is a text format column. Region, also text column. Unit sold, which is a number. Revenue, which is a currency. And customer satisfaction that is going from 1 to 5. And starting from this data right here, we can import our data here to Looker Studio. You can go here to create and then and select report. And this is how you start creating a report in Looker Studio or a dashboard. And you can see all the data sources available for Looker Studio. Some of them are first party and other ones are third party, where you may wanna, which they might need a more complex setup, but still this is the easiest way to start importing data from your data source. And this instance, we're gonna use Google Sheets. If I click here on Google Sheets, it's gonna show me the way I have on my Google Drive. And these are some of the Google Sheet files that I have used recently. So I'm gonna select the spreadsheet one, which that's the name of the spreadsheet we're gonna import data to. And here are some options to import the data. Honestly, this is something already as a preset, so it doesn't matter. You can start with add and you can add to report. And here you will see we start with a table, which is displaying our data. And here are a few sections. Here is where you can start making changes to the visualizations that you have selected. Right now it's the table is selected and that's being counted as a visualization. But then we have here our data that we are importing from Google Sheets. From here, we can start adding our visualizations. Let's delete this one. This is just a preview of our data. And you can go here to add a chart. And let's say we want donut chart to start seeing what's the percentages of each product. You can see here, it already created a preset for the donut chart. And here is where we can set up all the data, the visualizations with the data that we want. And right now it's showing column product, and it's also showing the record count as how many of these categories are in the data. But record count is basically the amount of rows that have that amount of categories. So let's change it here to unit sold instead of record count, and it's creating a sum. And you can see here it changed the numbers. Then we can make some other changes here to the visualization. We go here to style. We can start making changes to the visualization, but just on the outside. And I can add a title. It can be auto-generated depending on the data that I've selected for this visualization. We can also change the font. We can also change the radius, and each visualization is gonna have a different set of controls here for style. It's depending on the visualization itself. And you can see here we have many settings, and let's add another chart. I wanna add a column chart, and I can select the column chart and I click wherever I want the column chart to be. And you can see here again, it used as a default the categories for the products. Let's go again here on the visualization settings, and I can select here the region. And from the region, I can see how many units sold we have. And let's say I prefer to see what's the revenue. So I can drag and drop to metric, and I can delete here units sold, and it's gonna show the revenue. And then again, we have other settings here on the setup for the visualization. And if we go here to style, we can show the label, data labels. We can make the numbers compact if we need to. And we can also change the color of the visualization. But yeah, these are the types of things you can do here with this visualization specifically. And let's say I want to change this metric to show dollars. So I can go here to the metric edit. I can go here on data type, and it's not actually a number, it's actually a currency. So I'm going to select USD dollars, and you can see here the visualization changed. And let's add one last control here, or chart, sorry. And we can select the scorecard. And let's say I want to see the, as a default, it's selected units sold, but I actually want to see revenue. So I can drag and drop revenue from the list of the fields that I have on the data. And let's change this again to currency. And here is the currency. So the one of the perks of creating dashboards or reports using Looker Studio, it's that every time these are visualizations more dynamic than Google Sheets actually allows. So let's say I want to filter by laptop. And this is as intuitive as clicking on here on the laptop. And you can see it already filtered the data or the results of all the visualizations to this specific product. And I can do the same selecting the region. Let's say I want to select North. It actually updated this part of the unit sold and also the revenue. If you want to filter more specifically, you can go here on add a control, and you have all these controls for filter. And let's say right now I want to have the date range control. And from here, this one will automatically show me out of date range based on the data that I have available for this report specifically. And you can see here each one of these visualizations here have a date range dimension. In this case, it's using the date that we have on our source data source. So it's actually filtering all the results based on that. And yeah, you can select here the start date and the end date. And now that we have our dashboard ready to share with our stakeholders or audience, we can go here on the share button. And from here, we can select what type of settings we're going to be sharing this report to someone. And let's say I'm going to share it with John Smith. And I can send it here, and I can select here if I want him to be just a viewer or an editor as well. And you can also select if you want to notify them by email. And then you can click send here, and they will receive an invitation so they can see the report that you've just created. And from here, whenever they click on the link that you sent to them, they will have a view kind of like this one. So you can preview whenever you're editing the report, you can preview how's the report gonna look like when anyone enters the report. And this is how you can share the report to someone else. And this way you will avoid them to look at the underlying data that it's powering all these visualizations. And also it's gonna give you peace of mind that no one is gonna break the report that you just shared with them. So, if you've been struggling with spreadsheets and want a better way to manage your reports, Looker Studio is the way to go. Now that you know how to set up a dashboard, you might be wondering, what if my data isn't clean enough to use? Don't worry, I got a separate video where I break down how to clean and organize messy data before bringing them into Looker Studio. Check it out next. And if the video helped, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment below. Let me know what's the biggest challenge you face with spreadsheets.